All right, shalom, shalom. First and foremost, just as always, I'd like to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashem Yahushai, Bahashem Rakak Wadash, which is the Paleo Hebrew of the name of the Heavenly Father, the Ancient of Days, the Creator of all energy, being Yahweh, and that of the Messiah, whom the world ignorantly calls Jesus, being Yahushai. Those are the only names in which salvation may be obtained, whether you have been given the Spirit to receive that knowledge or not. I'd like to give double honors unto the elders and the apostles at GMS Grand Millstone who have taught me this truth through the spirit and power of Yahweh Bashim Yahushai, and who do rule well today, once again, whether you've been given the spirit to receive that knowledge or not, in peace, love, blessing, salutations, be unto the elect of the nation of Israel, beginning with 144,000 prophets, all the way down to the remaining elect of our nation prophesied to come out of the lies and out of the deceits of this world, in return unto the identity and the knowledge of who we truly are, man. You see, which we are not blacks, Hispanics, or Native Americans. We are, in fact, the 12 tribes of Israel prophesied to lose our heritage, to be led into slavery, captivity, and to take on the curse of having the base of man strip our identity from us. And when I say the base of man, I'm saying Esau, Edom, you see, according to the scriptures, whose modern identity would be the so-called Caucasoid, the so-called white man. You see, here it is, all nations have been given a particular role to play on this earth, just like we went in on the last lesson, how the Heavenly Father is the controller, man. You see, this is his story, this is his script, and he created vessels to fulfill their role in this script, man. It's not like a modern day movie where, you know, you go and you have particular people that their job task is to go find people to fit the role that was created within the script, man. You see, in this context, the Heavenly Father created the creation and created each vessel to fulfill its role, man. Which is why Esau has done a great job at being the devil. Which is why, you know, all flesh is subject to what, man? To prophecy. You see, that's ultimately what it is at the end of the day, man. The prophecies of Yahweh by Shem Yahushai. But let me go ahead and start off in the book of Romans here. You know, and I'm just kind of going through the spirit, man. Lord willing, this be edifying unto the elect. This is the book of Romans, chapter 9. Chapter 9 and verse 22. It says, what if God, willing to show his wrath to make his power known, endured with much long suffering the vessels of wrath fitted to destruction. So he created vessels of wrath that were fitted, that were created, that were made to what? To be destroyed, man. This is why, you know, lately I've been in the spirit of calling the peons the extras, man. All they are is the extras in the movie. You see? Then you have the two-thirds. Then you have the one-third, those who are prophesied to receive mercy. And I'm about to get this scripture to prove on both ends of the spectrum that the Heavenly Father chooses both those to be destroyed, as we just read, as well as those to be preserved, to be given mercy from the very foundation of this planet Earth, man. But anyway, this is the book of Job. Chapter 21 and verse 29, it says, have ye not asked them that go by the way, and do ye not know their tokens, that the wicked is reserved to the day of destruction? They shall be brought forth to the day of wrath. So the wicked has been reserved to be what? To be destroyed, man. That's what the Heavenly Father has put into this script. You see, somebody had to be the wicked So he created the wicked. That's why the book of Psalms says this. It says, Psalms chapter 34 and verse 16, it says, "The face of Yahweh is against them that do evil, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth." You see, to cut off the remembrance of them from the earth, man. So these particular vessels fitted to wrath, fitted to destruction, as we just read out of the book of Romans, you see, have been created and preserved and have played their role. You see, and when I say preserved, I mean they've been void of judgment, man. You see, these people have not been judged the way that they should be for their actions. They've been allowed to do worse and worse things, crimes against not only our people, but really against humanity itself, man. As the scriptures say, "He enlargeth his desire as hell," you see, quoting the book of Habakkuk, "and he is as death," man. This man is the harbinger of death. He's brought nothing but cruelty and wickedness and death upon this earth, man. And he will pay for it. Be not deceived. Though you see him looking prosperous or whatever the case may be, as the scriptures are saying, man, envy him not. You see, because his day will come, man. His day will come. This is, let's see, this is the book of, I'll grab one more out of Psalms here. This is Psalms chapter 37. And verse 8. We'll go to verse 7. It says, "Rest in Yahweh and wait patiently for him. Fret not thyself because of him who prospereth in his way." You see, who prospereth in his way. Fret not thyself because of him. Though you see him prospering, you see, going on, it says, "Because of the man who bringeth wicked devices to pass." You see, they're prospering by their wickedness, man. You see, the product of Babylon, for example, man. Esau came over here, enslaved, raped, robbed, and murdered the people. You see, brought in more and more slaves. You see, collectively started, you know, flooding Israel to this great captivity to build this land. And you see them flourishing within it, man. That's why you have all these talks of reparations and payback, man. All these songs, you know, within hip-hop and you know, oldies that are, you know, talking about the day that we're going to get back, man. And you have, you know, even particular, you know, groups, you know, revolutionary groups or whatever you want to call it, man, that are out there in the world that are doing particular moves to bring things to pass, such as reparations, man. But according to the scriptures, the Heavenly Father is going to bring it to pass. You see, the world lacks faith, man. The world has been taught to think carnally, because the ruler of this current world is someone who thinks carnally. As I mentioned at the beginning of this lesson, the base of man who is ruling over us, man. As it is written in the book of Job 9 and 24, "The earth has been given into the hand of the wicked. He covereth his faces of the judges thereof." You see, so he's covered the faces of true judgment, man. These true judges on this earth, who were the Israelites, who were given the law to judge, you see, according to the Heavenly Father's law, not according to anything else, which is why they were given that law. They've been covered, man. We've lost who we were, and here we are in the world trying to find an identity among the world, man, which is why we have these labels such as blacks, Hispanics, Native Americans, you see, whatever it is that you want to call yourself, man. At the end of the day, we are the 12 tribes of Israel, and just as it was prophesied that we would lose our heritage in the book of Jeremiah, the 16th chapter, you see, it was also prophesied that we would return, Ezekiel 37, the Valley of Dry Bones, man. You see many, many, many precepts. And this is why the book of Revelation, you see, and I know I'm, you know, paraphrasing, so, you know, I'll go ahead and make sure I'm grabbing, you know, grabbing some precepts here too. But this is the book of Revelation chapter 2. And verse 9, and it reads, I know thy works and tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. So the Heavenly Father is saying, I see what you're going through, man. I see your works. I see your tribulation. I see your poverty. You see, but you are rich. How are we rich? Because at the end of the day, man, we have something that's been promised to us. And what is that? The covenant that we have with the Heavenly Father, that the earth will be inherited by us. You see, this is a promise that we have with the Heavenly Father. You see, so we have the covenant with him, which is why we were given the law, which is why at the end of the day, what's that covenant going to lead to? This is the book of Daniel chapter 7 and verse 17. It's lucky, verse 18. It says, but the saints of the Most High shall take the kingdom and possess the kingdom forever, even forever and ever. You see that, man? The saints of the Most High will take and possess the kingdom. You see, that's what we've been promised, man, the kingdom. You see, in our time, the rule everlasting is coming, man. We're the only ones prophesied to have that forever and ever rule. Esau doesn't have that. No nation on this earth has that, man. You see? So at the end of the day, we are the ones who are rich. We are the ones who will be delivered. Therefore, don't fret yourself because of evildoers, man. This alone shows and proves the power of the Most High. This is the book of Zephaniah chapter 3 and verse 19. Behold, at that time, I will undo all that afflict thee, and I will save her that halteth and gathereth her that was driven out. Talking about you Israelites, man. We've halted. We've been cut off, you see. But yet the Heavenly Father has caused this plant to live and to flourish through the elect, man. You see? That's why the book of Romans, the 11th chapter, talks about what, man? The being grafted into this tree again. You see? We're once part of something, we got cut out, and now we're being brought back in again. The prodigal son, right? It says, and gathereth her that was driven out. I will get them praise and fame in every land where they have been put to shame. So the Heavenly Father is going to gather us out of every land. Those of us who are taking on this act of repentance by the law that we were given and returning to the Heavenly Father and preparing to rule in this world to come, man. Which this all takes faith to be done. Without faith, you would be out there in some kind of, you know, Black Lives Matter or some bullshit like that. That ain't going to bring nothing to pass, man. You see? All the marching and all everything, all these vain works that our people have done that have brought us nothing. They haven't gotten us anywhere, man. You see? The Heavenly Father actually told us the one way it would be done. 1 Corinthians, the first chapter, and I believe the 24th verse, which was what? By the foolishness of preaching. That's how the Heavenly Father will save us, man. That's how the Heavenly Father will restore immortality to us, the kingship to us, man. The promise that he gave us. That's how it'll come to pass, you see? And for those of you who are taking part in that, you know, in that calling, that makes up those of the elect who, as I mentioned earlier, were chosen since the foundation of the world. This is the book of Ephesians, chapter 1 and verse 4. It says, according as he hath chosen us in him before the foundation of the world, that we should be holy and without blame before him in love, having predestinated us unto the adoption of children by Yahawashi HaMashiach to himself according to the good pleasure of his will. So you see that? So according to his good pleasure, according to what he wanted to do, what he saw fit, according to how he wanted this movie to be acted. You see? He chose what? To predestinate some to be adopted back into Yahweh through Yahweh Shai, man. And what did it say? Verse 4, according as he hath chosen us before him, before the foundation of the world. So before the earth was even created, the Heavenly Father had chosen out who was going to play the role of his elect, man. You see? Again, this shows the power of the Most High, and this should strike fear within us, man. Why? Because we know and understand that this is the creator of all energy. You see? There's nothing else on this earth to be feared. What did Yahweh Shai tell Pontius Pilate? You could do nothing, but it was given unto you by my Father, man. The Heavenly Father is the one that's in control. He controls these vessels, man. There might be a psychopath killer, you see? And that psychopath killer, he's going to meet his end as well. You see? He got stirred up to deliver these particular portions of judgment, but yet he himself is also a man. So he's also going to be judged. The Heavenly Father used this vessel to take care of these other vessels, and ultimately that wound up in the end of the killer. You know, the original vessel, man. But anyway, I'm going to go ahead and jump back to... Oh, Salaki, I didn't finish that Revelation 2 and 9. So I know thy works, thy tribulation and poverty, but thou art rich. And I know the blasphemy of them that say they are Jews and are not, but are the synagogue of Satan. You see? So these people who are out there, you see these, the so-called Jewish community, they're not suffering, man. They're not under these curses. The first thing that proves that those people out there are not the true Israelites, man. You see? And in particular, this verse is really getting on, you know, the Israelites that are in the know of them being Israel, man. Because in this context, he's getting on the particular, you know, churches that are out there. You see? He's also saying, you know, I know these, you know, these Israelites that are out here that aren't Israelites, man. They may be Israelites in the flesh. They may have the garments. They may have all, you know, the fringes of the wazoo, man. But at the end of the day, they ain't Israelites on the inside. They haven't taken on that spiritual circumcision. They're still caught in the old ways. You see? So the Heavenly Father has everybody panned out to play their part, man. Those who are of the elect, those who are in here faking the funk, those who are in here to deceive, those who took the bag, man. That's why they got all these different camps out here, man. Camps that got women involved. Camps, they got a category for every camp out there, man. They got a camp for every category out there. You see? So you're able to, you know, bend whatever you want to your will. And just as this world has taught us, man, you're able to bring down the Heavenly Father to your mind frame, man. And lean on that. But as the scriptures say, what? My ways are not your ways, man. You are sorely mistaken. At the end of the day, man, we serve the creator of all energy. And his will come to pass, man. And this is what strikes the fear within us to what? To follow Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. To give up your lives in this world for Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai. Because the only reason why you're even able to breathe, why you're even able to have received anything, you see, good or bad, is because of Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai, man. This is the book of Psalms, going back where we left off, chapter 37 and verse 8. It says, cease from anger and forsake wrath. Fret not thyself in any wise to do evil. Because naturally, what is this going to do, man? The condition of the evildoers, man, as the book of Ecclesiastes tells us. Because sentence is not set against an evil work speedily, it's set in the sons of men to do evil, man. So because they're not seeing, you know, they may commit adultery and they may not be put to death right then and there, you see, allows them to go and do it more and more and more. But the Heavenly Father will bring that judgment upon you, man. The world, today's world, likes to call it the universe, right? They like to call it karma. Well, according to the scriptures, this is judgment, man. You see? Let me go ahead and go on. And it's going to come to all, though, everybody on this earth, man. You see? And that's why we're choosing what? To be judged now, to be corrected now, so that later on we may receive a reward, man. Going on, verse 9. But for those of you who ain't taking part in that, man, you're going to, you saving your judgment for the grand finale. You see? It says, for evildoers shall be cut off. So he's saying what? Don't worry. Don't do no wicked, man. Don't do no wickedly. What do you have with Shai tell Simon Peter, I believe it was, that cut off the Pharisee's ear, man. They had the Edomite came and put hands on Yahweh Shai, and he pulled his sword out and chopped off one of the Pharisees' ears. Yahweh Shai told him, "Get behind me, Satan," because at the end of the day, what was he doing, man? He was fighting against the will of the Most High. If Yahweh Shai wanted to, what did it say that he's able to bring legions of angels down, man? Which I believe a legion is 7,000. So he's able to bring down thousands upon thousands of angels to destroy, to conquer, man. But yet he had to fulfill his role as the vessel that he played to be sinless in the flesh, for his blood to be spilt to atone for the sins of the elect and not those of his own sins, as he had none. You see? It says, so yeah, man, don't fret yourself because of evildoers. Going on, what did it say? But those that wait upon the Lord shall inherit the earth. In other words, you see, a good precept for that would be Revelation chapter 13 and verse 9. If any man have an ear, let him hear. He that leadeth into captivity. And you're going to notice at the end of this 10th verse, I'm going to read the end real quick. It says, here is the patience and the faith of the saints. So with the context of what this verse is going to say, you see, this is likened unto the patience and the faith that the saints of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai would have. This is what gives us that patience and faith. Knowing, as we just read in Psalms, the 37th chapter, that the evildoers will be cut off. So don't fret. Don't worry about their bullshit, man. The book of Revelations also tells, I'll grab it. Let me go ahead and finish this real quick. It says, he that leadeth into captivity will go into captivity. He that killeth with the sword must be killed with the sword. So they're going to pay for their crimes, man. They're going to pay for the things that they have done. So don't worry, man. Don't fret. This is the book of Revelation chapter 22 and verse 11. He that is unjust, let him be unjust still. So, is the scriptures now contradicting itself, man? We were told to what? To go feed thy sheep? To go push this word day in and day out? The book of Isaiah tells us to hold not thy peace, day nor night. Never be silent, man. But yet right here, it's telling you, let the wicked be wicked still. Well, that's because what? We're commanded to go push. We're commanded to go preach. As the book of Ezekiel tells us, we're washing the blood off our hands, man. We're the watchmen. We see the judgment coming. So we're warning the people of that judgment. All right? But that's likened unto us washing blood off our hands, because their blood is on our hands if we're not going to tell them that they're going to be judged, man. You see? So that's simply what we're doing, man. Pushing this word. The elect are going to hear it in whatever. We don't got to sweeten it up in any way, because as we're reading, the Heavenly Father has already sealed his elect, man. So they're gonna receive this word in whatever way, shape, or form the Heavenly Father brings it to them, man. It may be in a rap, you know, some mainstream rap song. You know, maybe somebody listened to Kendrick Lamar and he mentioned the Hebrew Israelites and a brother looked it up. It may be because he walked past the camp. It may be because he stumbled upon a video. It may be because their cousin came into the truth, man. It may be because they were, sold out. Maybe they were sent there as a spy, and the Heavenly Father caused that route to take place, and them to see that everything we're saying is all according to the prophecies, man. We don't say nothing without this word, man. You see, this word is truly what speaks for us, man. We just try to break it down so that the elect could grasp it. But at the end of the day, man, as I mentioned, the elect are going to grasp it whatsoever way, shape, or form the Heavenly Father has planned for them to receive it. So at the end of the day, man, don't fret about the wicked and don't pull your hair out about the righteous neither, man. At the end of the day, you concentrate on your own salvation in fear and trembling. You repent. Repentance began, or salvation begins with the repentance of Israel, man. How are you going to sit out here and complain about the issues on this earth, but yet you're taking part in them, man? You're over here committing adultery, and then you're over here complaining because somebody committed adultery on you. At the end of the day, man, let the wicked be wicked still, and let the righteous be righteous still. The Heavenly Father has already panned everything out according to prophecy, man. In other words, the truth shall set you free. We don't got to go and figure out some huge breakdown, the blueprints of how each brother's going to receive it, how we need to present. I need to be a rap, Israelite rapper, man. The scripture said the foolishness of preaching. We don't got to figure none of that bullshit out. All we got to do is preach, man. All we got to do is push the word. You see, that's all that matters. Anything outside of that is superfluous, man. Going on, it says, verse 11 of Revelation 22, it says, let him be filthy still. He that is filthy, let him be filthy still. And he that is righteous, let him be righteous still. And he that is holy, let him be holy still. Behold, I come quickly, and my reward is with me to give every man according to his work shall be. So he's going to come and establish that judgment. Judgment isn't always a bad thing, man. In fact, if you, you know, if you're in need of help, you're looking for someone to come and judge your cause, right? So that's what we're calling out for, man. Heavenly Father to judge us, but not in wrath, in mercies. You see, in mercies abundantly, man. Come and judge the case that we have in this earth, man. And Lord willing, we could receive the crown. And Lord willing, everything that we receive up until that point of the crown will cause us to harden, to endure. As long as you endure the hardship, man, you will grow from it. You see? But anyway, this is Psalms chapter 37 and going on, verse 9. It says, for the evildoers shall be cut off, but those that wait upon the Lord, they shall inherit the earth. For yet a little while, and the wicked shall not be. Yeah, thou shalt diligently consider his place, and it shall not be. But the meek shall inherit the earth, and shall delight themselves in the abundance of peace. The wicked plotteth against the just, and gnasheth upon him with his teeth. The Lord shall laugh at him, for he seeth that his day is coming. So, hey, man, the Heavenly Father's just sitting back like this, man. Just sitting back watching Esau act the way he is. You know, it's like you over there getting bullied on the playground, and your older brother, little does anybody know. You see, he's on that playground, man. He's on that same playground, but just right around the corner doing this, watching everything that's going on, man. Getting ready for it to be his turn. Getting ready to come and deliver his brother, man. You see? Going on, it says, he said, what? He sees his day coming, man. So the Heavenly Father has Yahweh Shai just waiting, man. Has the angels just waiting. Yahweh Shai was, that's the mind frame he was in at the time of him being crucified, man. Knowing and understanding the power that he was going to return with, man. What did it say? I shall not meet thee as a man. He had to overcome that in order to receive everything. Satan was over there in the wilderness, what, trying to offer him what's already his, man. Man, why am I going to take this from you when I'm going to receive it in righteousness? Because that's the role that I was given, man. The wicked shall not be. So if I'm going to be the wicked, that means that really you're giving me an empty promise. Right? Verse 14, it says, the wicked have drawn out the sword and have bent their bow to cast the poor and the needy, to slay such as be of upright conversation. Yeah, so they're killing us, man. Putting hands upon us, plotting against us, right? Verse 15, their sword shall enter into their own heart. But the Heavenly Father is going to have what? The things be turned around. It says, and their bows shall be broken. A little that a righteous man hath is better than the riches of many wicked. You see that, man? A little that a righteous man hath is better than the riches of many wicked, man. Why? Because they're prophesied to end. So they're over here running their mouth and, you know, putting all their stuff on blast when you know damn well it all belongs to you, man. So just as I mentioned earlier, man, Yahweh's sitting here like this. Yahweh Shai, hey, that's the same with us, man. Sitting here like this, waiting. Watching. As prophecy unfolds. As we work out our salvation in fear and trembling. As we push this word. And you see the elect being sealed all throughout the earth. Esau has all these missionaries out there, man. These goddamn Mormons. You know, all these people going door to door and stuff, man. Jehovah's Witnesses, man. That's because what? The Heavenly Father ain't with that mess, man. The Heavenly Father put the Spirit within Abba Bivens and the elders and the apostles on down to begin putting videos up, man. And then they began to be used on the internet, man. The unicorn, as the scriptures were prophesied. And eventually, now you have Israelites throughout the whole world, man. You don't see us traveling from country to country, state to state. You know, I mean, you know, brothers got business and what have you. But at the end of the day, man, we don't need to do that. Because the Heavenly Father is that powerful. And this is the truth. And this is the proof. So with that, Lord willing, this is edifying, man. Do not fret. Stay patient that we may receive the prize. I'm going to give all praises, honor, and glory unto Yahweh, Bahashim Yahushah, Bahashim Rakah Kodash, double honors unto Yahweh, the apostles at GMS Great Millstone, and peace, love, blessing, salutations unto you sincere members of the elect out there, man. Shalom.